Hello friend, today we will talk about the COVID-19 compliance checklist. COVID-19 compliance checklist is as per Aramco, we already implemented in our company, and all contractor who is working with the Aramco, they should do it. There is a total 9 points. Digits reporting and awareness, the first point. Second point is main entrance and area posture. The third point is housekeeping management. The fourth point is cleaning materials. Fifth point is janitor, personal hygiene, PPE, personal protect equipment. And the sixth is supervision. Seven, bathrooms. Eight, food security. And the ninth, last one, it's facilities. So let's start the videos. We will discuss about it one by one. So please stay on my channel.
So before we start, now I want to show you how you will make the format. As you can see here, create COVID-19 company compliance checklist. The first title is you need to put the company name and location, number of occupants, date and proponent, and completed by name and with the position. Action: completed checklist to be sent to proponent, copied to contractor company. All those items believe repeated as a no are to be corrected in the next 3 days, and action taken reported to the proponent. This is reporting and awareness. So let's start with the inside the disease reporting awareness. There is a first: a company management conduct a toolbox talk and provide poster to ensure all occupants know the COVID-19 symptom. And the second is company occupants are given training in 7 movements and hand hygiene and cough etiquette. See, company management have a COVID-19 company orientation in place for all company visitors. Check if any symptoms, follow hand hygiene, washing and sanitizer rule. D, all occupants have a temperature monitor before they leaving the company, and for visitors on arrival using a non-contact thermometer to identify fever at or above 37.8 degrees Celsius, recorded note. Check without promoting if they know this temperature, mouth thermometer are not to be used due to risk of cross infection. Visit to the company by friend and relative are prohibited. F, there are no gathering in the company to ensure social distancing, especially during meal time. Dining rooms, gym, mosque, TV rooms to be closed. Identify temporary isolation holding room for suspected case away from other occupants until transfer to hospital. Remove unnecessary furniture extra so that easy to clean and disinfect. If you have this one, so you can say yes, either you can say no. Management know the MOH reporting rules and ensure all occupants are familiar with COVID-19 symptoms. Management keep and update illness logbook on site and record name, symptoms and action taken, ES code and company GI requirements. All occupants have medical insurance coverage. All occupants have valid health certificate. Employee have a completed health declaration form after traveling abroad. After an isolation period, employees have a medical checkup and receive a health certificate before being allowed to return to the work. So here there is a 6 point. So if there is any partial, so you can mention here by partial, either you can say yes or no. Management have a hospital referral plan in case an occupant display symptom of COVID-19, record keep of the employee data and contact number. When employee return from hospital, there are records or certificates to show advice given by hospital and action to be taken. On-site medical personnel, where applicable, have relevant PPE available in clinic to protect themselves from suspected infected occupant or patient. No overcrowding, identify any dormitory room, do not meet the space requirement of 4.6 square meters per person. Remove equipment from overcrowded room and relocate them. Now we will move on second point, main entrance and area posters. Display two posters, seven moments for hand washing and cuff etiquette at main entrance and main communal area such as dining room. Provide hand washing poster in the bathroom. Ensure hand sanitizer available at all main entrance, bathroom and kitchen wash bin. Alcohol percentage 60% to 90%. Ensure regularly checked and resupplied. Third point. 3. Housekeeping management. Identify high touch, high traffic areas. Example, door handles, stairs, banister, etc. List them, record and state frequency of cleaning and disinfection hourly. Have a cleaning and disinfection plan in place in case they have to deal with suspected or confirmed case camp, decontamination squad or decontamination team with staff, trained equipment identified to be used. PPE to be provided such as disposal, coverall or gowns, double disposal, gloves, face mask, eye protection, disposal shoes, covers. Cleaning schedule provide for facility state the frequency of general cleaning, what will be cleaned and chemical use, example, corridor floor twice daily using detergent, decommentary rooms weekly using vacuum cleaner and wet dusting with detergent, etc. Note, there must be very high basic cleaning arrangement in place. Provide disinfection chemical bleach hypochlorite solution based on 5.25% hypochlorite product such as Colrex, prepared for use at 1 part to 50 parts water as 1:50 or other EPD approved chemical disinfectant. See mixing chart below. Leave copy on site. As you can see, this is the chart. Guidance to stabilize dilution rate for Colrex hypochlorite. Check the product bottle is 5.25%. This is based on 5.25% product. How to understand and implement the flowing chart. So you can see this is the chart. So you can implement and you can make
it. So we will move now point number 4. Point number is cleaning materials. In the cleaning material, provide a bleach hypochlorite solution such as Colrex. No other type of disinfectant solution is to be used unless approved by EPD. You should notice here, this note, Dettol is not approved. Proponent to contact EPD if advice required. Provide color-coded J cloth and disposal clean cloth tissue, reusable J cloths must be disinfected between areas. Note, treat J cloth as waste flowing suspected or confirm contact disinfection. Provide a written disinfection procedure inside plastic cover in each of cleaning trolleys. Ensure mop cloth, buckets, other cleaning materials that are reusable are clean and disinfected regularly after each shift. Replace old or damaged wooden handle with plastic handle that can easily disinfected. Ensure routine cleaning materials, detergent, extra and bleach, hypochlorite, Colrex disinfectant are provided with sufficient resupply. Ensure cleaning clothes are kept clean. Mop, sink,
where supplied must have running water supply. Provide plentiful supply waste bag. Provide provide instruction for janitor to follow for mixing bleach, hypochlorite, chloride solution. You can see mixing chart above. Translation is as required. Ensure bleach hypochlorite solution Corex is freshly made on daily basis. Ensure a spray bottle labeled with date prepared. Do not use if older than 24 hours. Ensure hypochlorite solution Corex made to correct concentration product at 5.2%. Concentration is diluted at 1:50 water C. See mixing chart above. Provide alcohol solution 70% at least for high touch area where Coldrex cannot to be used. So always you can see here you need to put yes or no. So let's move on point number 5. It's called janitor's personal hygiene and PPE. So what is here in point number 5? Ensure janitors have high standard of personal hygiene. Ensure they can describe the 7 moments for hand hygiene. Provide corrective PPE, disposable gloves, surgical face mask. Face mask change every 4 hours or if wet. For suspect contact or contact cleaning and disinfection, refer to MOH guidance for additional PPE. Note, thread used PPE as waste flowing suspected or confirmed contact disinfection. Ensure janitor have plentiful supply of disposable gloves. They will require several gloves change a day. Ensure janitors have enough change of uniform provided and laundry arrangement for fresh uniform each day. Ensure can describe correct cleaning and disinfection procedure and can demonstrate this if asked. So now we will move with the point number 6. It's called supervision. Ensure supervisors are aware of frequency of cleaning and disinfection for each area. Identify on a schedule at 9 and 10. Ensure supervisor conduct inspection of janitor activities report and follow up action. Point number 7, it's called bathrooms. In the point number 7, in the bathroom, ensure all sink working with the warm running water, liquid hand soap dispensers with sign and disposable towels. Do not allow share use of bar of soap or towels. Ensure detergent bottles, sanitizer bottles, towel dispensers are full, regularly checked and restocked. Ensure waste bin are lined with the disposable plastic bag and regularly empty it. So now we will talk about the point number 8. It's a very important point, food safety. In the food safety, there is a point. Ensure food safety management enforced and meet EH code such as temperature monitoring, HACCP, etc. Ensure high standard of food safety and hygiene are enforced. Central catering. Ensure dishwasher, if applicable, have the rinse cycle operating at 82 degrees centigrade or higher. Sink use check using the 3 sink method, first flush and scrub equipment and utensil sink. One shock in hot detergent solution 35 degrees centigrade or above UG cleaning agent. Sink 2, immer and rinse above 35 degrees. Sink 3rd, soak in 100 ppm chlorine wear gloves for minimum 30 seconds minimum. Note, if combined detergent sanitizer is used and is non-chlorine, best extend contact time to 1 minute at 24 centigrade. Check manufacturer safety guidance. Actually, the central catering, it's some of the company have a catering, some of the country don't have a catering. So it's a common. So you can say yes or no, or either you have a, some of the company have a self catering. So we go with the self catering. Occupant cook their own and wash their utensils. Provide the adequate arrangement to clean and disinfect the utensil and equipment. Adequate number of double or triple sink in it, provided with the hot water 35 degree. Occupant shock utensils and 100 ppm chlorine. Wear gloves for minimum 30 second minimum. CS recommends disposal plates, cups and cutlery provided in visual salt success etc. suggest provided. Note, if not enough sink provided, temporary provide a large container or large plastic basins in the kitchens to allow this, and change the solution frequently until more sink in it are installed. Ensure dining table and hand contact part of are frequently cleaned and disinfected. Hypochlorous solution. Ensure employee wash hand before eating. Conduct toolbox talk to emphasize this. Ensure employee are issued bottle of hand sanitizer 60 to 90% alcohol. If working in area where they cannot wash hand before eating food. Let's move point number 9. It's called facility. In the facility, laundry provide adequate number of washer and dryers, 2 washer, 2 dryer for each 50 occupants. Ensure hot water cycle operates. Shower, ensure adequate number of shower that function fully with the warm water. Refer EH code page 184, scale of provision. Example, for 80-100 occupants, 12 showers. Bathroom wash bin, ensure number provider meets EH code. Example, for 80-100 occupants, 12 wash bin must be in good state of repair and capable of being easily cleaned. Ensure central kitchen have wash bin provided near where food handlers prepare food. Provide wash bin in kitchen where contractor prepare their own food. This must separate from sink unit. Bathroom ventilation, ensure AC fully operational. Encourage occupants to open window to natural ventilation. Improve the general standard of cleaning in all areas. Location not to be unsatisfactory. State what and where.
That's it for now. I hope you enjoy my video. Until now, you did not subscribe my channel, subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press on bell icon. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.